28 years ago, my father was taken away from me and my siblings. My father was later convicted to life under a mandatory minimum sentence. I remember being on the phone with my dad and asking him, "Do you mean forever? Is this forever?" It becomes this emotional roller coaster that we lived for so many years.
Me cuidó de lo que era toda la delincuencia o todos los temas que siempre estaba mi viejo. Viví unos temas de violencia, como por ejemplo cuando era chico en los allanamientos. Esas experiencias me quedaron muy marcadas cuando revivieron, cuando era más grande. A los 19 años, cuando volví a tener un allanamiento en mi casa, donde me tiraron al piso, donde me pusieron, como yo cuento, una bota en la cabeza, donde la verdad yo sufrí bastante y fue como volver a sentir y vivir lo mismo que tenía reprimido cuando era chico.
And he's like, "Ebony, no matter how much I've changed, no matter how much my life's changed, no matter how the laws have changed, this, what they're saying is that this is forever."
Dad went away 4 weeks ago. It's been a bit rubbish since then. At first I thought he was away working, that's what I was told. But now I know that's not true. I feel really let down. I hate lies, and not telling me that Dad was in prison was a big fat one. I knew something was wrong, but I never guessed that's what it was. I felt angry, then I felt scared, then I felt sad. Nice combination. I'm worried about Dad. Is he locked up all day? What is prison really like? Is it an awful place? Are they even feeding him properly? Why has this happened? Did I do something wrong? So many questions buzzing in my head. It feels like it's going to pop. Questions, questions, questions. What's wrong? Are you feeling okay? You're so grumpy these days. I've been yawning all the time. No wonder. I can't sleep properly just now. So even my teacher asked if everything was all right. I wanted to scream. "No, it's not!" But I said, "Yeah, fine." Why did I do that? The truth is too scary to tell. I'm worried people will make fun of me if they find out. Even Jay, but I've known him since the first day of school. Maybe he won't be friends with me anymore. Good friends should care, shouldn't they? Maybe I will tell someone.
Listen, Alex, whatever it is that's on your mind, you don't have to tell us. But we're your friends, and you can always talk to us if you want.
It's just all this talk about my dad and where he is got me really upset.
Oh, because your daddy's away? And you miss him?
Yeah, but because of where he is, too. My dad's in jail.
In jail? Why?
I don't like to talk about it. Most people don't understand.
I miss her.
I'm glad he's away.
I want to see him.
It takes ages to get there.
I don't like the dogs.
The dog's really friendly.
I don't want to visit.
It's an adventure.
The noises are scary.
Visits are fun. Visits are boring.
There are toys and games.
There's nothing to do.
I just want to cuddle him.
I don't want to see her.
The officers are nice.
They look scary in their uniforms.
No one's telling me anything.
They explained what had happened.
They're all talking about me at school.
No one's talking to me at school.
I want to be like everyone else.
I want my teacher to know.
I don't want the school to know.
I wish I could call him when I wanted.
I like it when he calls me.
I've got so much to tell her.
I want to see my friends instead.
I want to talk about it.
I don't want to talk about it. I'm embarrassed.
I'm proud of him.
I'm sad.
Glad.
Afraid.
Relieved.
Shocked.
Angry.
Lonely.
Children affected by imprisonment don't just have one voice. Each year, there are 27,000 of us in Scotland alone. It's time to start listening.
Over 10 million children at some point in their life have been impacted by parental incarceration in the United States. That is an epidemic. 10 million people are walking around with this pain, silently suffering? No, we gotta do something.
Discuss this with anybody because I never knew that anybody was going through this.
Y bueno, de ahí yo pude contar mi experiencia de cómo yo viví estos años con mi papá en la cárcel sin haberme enterado en tiempo, contando mis historias de dónde él estaba o de dónde no estaba, mintiéndome para mi familia me lo decía, mintiéndome para poder resguardarme y en cierto punto decidir por mí no contarme eso y que en verdad en mi opinión era todo lo contrario, me hubiera gustado saber más allá de que sea buena o mala la experiencia, saber qué había pasado y que aún en este tiempo ya habiendo dado varias entrevistas no logro poder tener esa intimidad con mi mamá para poder contar y que ella pueda hablarme sobre los hechos y cómo fue, simplemente me quedan los recuerdos que tengo.
I found out about my mum going to prison myself through the TV and papers. I was told that she's gone away, she was working away to try and be an air stewardess, or I'd get mixed things from different people. Like some would say, oh, she's off working away. Some would say, she's been a bit naughty and she's had to go away for a bit. Just silly little things at that age that they thought I'd believe. And every Christmas they'd be like, oh yeah, maybe she'll be home this Christmas. And she just never came, so I just kind of blocked it out, like it was just an everyday routine, just to sort of get on with it.
So basically I wanted to keep it a secret for them, because I suppose on some level I basically felt ashamed of my dad. Getting ashamed to admit he was a criminal and that.
They wanted to know more, but it's nothing to do with them. They never told like any of my pals or that.
They all tried to like sugar it up for me, because I was just a kid basically. So if anybody asked me, well, where's your dad? I'd say, oh, he's on holiday at this place and all.
I remember the first visit I ever had, and it looked like I was going to a really big Victorian old castle sort of thing. I just thought, what is this tomb? What are we going into? The prison was really dark and dull, and I felt quite claustrophobic. Every time I used to see her, I used to think, oh, well, she's coming back now, and she never did. I wouldn't want to let go of her hand, and sometimes the guard would just be like, you're going to have to go now. And it just broke my heart. I'd be clutching her finger, telling her, come on, let's go now. And she's like, I can't come.
They were visiting my cousin in prison. And we had to go through these big metal detectors, and I really hated it. My big cousin, they looked nothing like the other guys that were there. They were all rather scary. And their families weren't much better. And we kids screaming all over the place, women shouting at them, shouting at them, like whoever they were visiting and all that. Quite intimidating.
My father is an incredible dad. For the 28 years that he's been there, he has written us, he has called us almost every day. He has given us birthday cards, holiday cards. When I graduated, I got a graduation card. When I became a mother, I got flowers in my labor, in the hospital room. So many moments. You know, he hasn't been physically there, but his presence, despite prison walls, he has absolutely been an incredible dad. It's like emotional for me. So the fact that he's not here, to be a part of my son and my nephew's life, is really painful. It's really painful for me.
The United States is the great mass incarcerator. We are 5% of the world's population, and yet and still, we incarcerate the most people on the planet. The most people on the planet. And 2.3 million of those people that are incarcerated, 50% of them are parents. That's horrible. So I'm like, we gotta change that. So we have to make everybody aware. That's why We Got Us Now is here, so that we can make people aware of what's happening on the ground and make sure that people are advocating for our needs. We decided we are going to be accountable for us and not wait for someone else to do the work.
Eso creo que la palabra confusión es lo que explica todo, porque yo estaba en un punto donde la verdad todos me decían una cosa y yo pensaba otra. Y lo bueno es que cuando encontré la plataforma NAPES, encontré un lugar donde me pudieron escuchar, me hicieron sentir que no estaba loco, que no era que estaba pensando mal o pensaba de otra manera, sino que había gente que me apoyaba en ese pensamiento y que tenía lógica como yo lo pensaba. Yo siempre sufría mi adolescencia y en mi infancia también. Siempre quise tener un padre más presente. Pero bueno, también lo perdoné y también acepté que así es la vida. Y estoy contento también. Sé que tuvo cosas de mierda, como sé que mi papá también es ese tipo que íbamos a jugar al parque en bicicleta o íbamos a ver una película o me escuchaba tocando un poco de Bach. Él es todo eso y él es también son las cosas malas. No existe ni el bueno ni el malo, somos todo una mezcla. Pasa que uno tiene que tomar la decisión de qué camino, qué pintura más elegir. Creo que es un poco de lo que resume todos mis sentimientos. Tal vez cuando yo toco, eso lo uso como colores, ¿no? Yo mis sentimientos los uso como colores. Estas experiencias son las que al tocar me hacen vivir la música. Cuando toco, en cierto punto estoy tocando y haciendo sacar esa experiencia, que tal vez en las entrevistas también la empecé a sacar. Sentimientos, creo que poder tener una conexión donde uno pueda liberar, en mi caso fue la música, pero si cuando sos chico en una contención, para poder hablar esas cosas, creo que sería lo primero que se debería pensar y lo que más ayudaría a la gente. Yo lo digo, a los 18 años en una entrevista pude hablar de ese tema y nunca lo había hablado. No tuve un lugar, no tuve un medio. Tampoco tuve amigos para decirlo con tanta confianza porque me daba vergüenza. Algo que no me debería haber dado. Pero creo que tener un espacio. Si no hay nada, empezar a tener un espacio donde poder hablar, donde poder uno tomar esas herramientas y aprender a cómo utilizarlas, que creo que es lo que primero pensaría.
My mum is in prison. We don't talk much, but I have the right to send her letters. You too can keep in touch with your parent and remain close even when they are far away. When I see my dad, I always give him a big hug. If you need help keeping in touch, ask a grown-up you trust. Because it's our right to keep in touch with our parent.
Hey Mom, happy Mother's Day.
You are the coolest, most beautiful, and brilliant woman I've ever met.
Dear Mom, I missed you a lot. I can't do this.
I thank you for being there for me, writing letters to me.
Mom, I love you, and sometimes I want to bear hug you.
I love you.
And sometimes I might not show it, but I love you a lot. And please don't leave me like that again.